Hi, students of class 5, how are you all doing? Hope everybody is good and safe there. Children, this video you'll be learning about a snake charmer story, which is going to be the second chapter in your EBS. I think the first chapter most of you must have understood. So this chapter we'll be learning some of the interesting facts about snakes. Usually most of you will be scared of snakes, isn't it? I am scared of snakes. I know that few of you will be also scared of snakes. Okay, let's go into the chapter and find out who's explaining us a story and who are the characters in the story. All this I'll explain to your children. So in the page you can see that I'm Aryanath. Yes, so Aryanath is a boy. He's going to explain us a story about his grandfather. His grandfather was a snake charmer. What is the meaning of a snake charmer? Snake charmer is nothing but a person who catches the snake and then they play a music with the help of a bean. Yeah, bean is nothing but a musical instrument. And with the help of that musical instrument, when they play the music, the snake will dance according to the music what they play in the bean. Okay, and these people we call them as kalbelias. You must have come across this because in our school annual day, we also had a dance called Kalbelia in the previous year. Yes. So that kind of person or the person who will catch the snakes and then they make the snakes to play according to the tune what they play in the bean. Now, in the picture, what you see is the bean. Okay. This is made especially to catch the fish or in order to make catch the snake or in order to make the snake to dance according to the tune. Now Aryanath is gonna explain the story about his grandfather, because his grandfather's name is Roshan Netaji and he was the person who was a snake charmer. And he's an expert in catching many poisonous snakes. And now he's going to tell us the story about his childhood days and what all he did in the childhood days. All those things he's going to share with us. Shall we go into this and find out what all he did in the childhood, children? Yes? Okay. Now, only now we have television, we have mobile phones and all electronic gadgets we have at home. But in the olden days, no, not at all. What will they do? They used to go with their parents and the grandparents and learn whatever job those were doing. So that is how they learn many things. Yes, the same way grandfather of Aryanath also has did the same thing. He learned this snake charmer activity with the help of his grandfather and his great grandfathers. And you know, snakes are usually, if we see snakes, we will be scared of snakes. And these people, what they used to do, they used to carry the snakes in bamboo baskets. Yes, and whenever they come with bamboo baskets and start playing this music, what we do in a village, we'll all gather together and we'll stand around them and we'll see what these snake charmers are doing. Yes or no? Yes. And even after the show, people will stay on to ask them about how do you take care of these snakes? Are you not scared of snakes? What will you do if the snake come out of the basket? All these questions we have in our mind. Yes. So these people also who are gathered around the snake charmer were asking all these questions to them, to him. And finally, he told that I used to be with snakes from my childhood, so I don't have any fear of being with snakes. And you know one thing, he also could give medicines even if the doctors and hospitals are very far away. He knows to give medicines if the snake bites somebody. And you know that in few places when snakes are biting somebody, there are chances where it may cause death on the spot. Those are very poisonous snakes. But most of the snakes are non-poisonous. And even Amarnath's grandfather knows to identify from the snake bite that whether it is a bite of a poisonous snake or a non-poisonous snake. How did he manage to know all these things? It is all because of his experience. because he used to go with his grandfather and great grandfather and learn many things from them. And that is how he learned the differentiation between the poisonous and the non-poisonous snakes, and also to find out the medicine of the snake bite from the forest. All these he came to know. And one more interesting thing what Arinath's grandfather know about is, he also knows how to remove the poisonous teeth of the snake. What do you call the poisonous teeth of the snake? We call it as fangs. F-A-N-G-S. We call it as fangs. And also, he know how to close the tube of poison in the snake's mouth as well. So, these are the interesting things that the Arinath's grandfather has learned. Now, you will also feel to learn all these things from Arinath's grandfather, isn't it? Yes. So, I will share some of the videos with you, how to extract the fangs of poison from the fangs of the snake, and Kalbelia dance forms, all these I'll share to you in the next video, children. And I know that you'll all be curious about learning things like how to catch a snake, how to extract the poison from the snake, all these, yes? I am also excited to know that. So I will send you the video which is relating to extracting the poison from snake and catching a snake, all such things, so that you can enjoy those videos, children. And coming back to the chapter, Arinath was very much disappointed because he was not able to know anything about the snakes, because there was a law which has been imposed called the Animal Protection Act, in that we are not supposed to keep any of the wild animals at home. Few Kalbelia people, not only Kalbelia people, the other people, what they did was they cached the snake and they killed the snake and used the skin of the snake and sold it. So because of that, they were not allowed to use or keep any of the animals at home. That was the reason. And you know, the Kalbelia people treasure the snakes. And in Kalbelia dance, they all have the movements which are similar to the dance of a snake. And if you see the video of the Kalbelia dance, moreover, all the movements will be like a snake movement. Okay. And one more thing I wanted to ask you. Do you know who is the friend of the farmer? Who is the farmer's friend in the field? Yes, you're right. The farmer's friend is nothing but snake. Because how does the snake help the farmer? The snake is helping the farmer by catching the rats which are there in the field, because rats usually will spoil the crops. So the snake is helping to catch all the rats. Okay, so hope you must have learned some of the interesting and exciting facts about the snakes. So this was a story which has been told by the grandfather to the grandchildren. Also, you make a new story of your life to tell your grandchildren. Okay, hope you enjoyed this video, children. So if you have your textbook, you can just go through the chapter. By the time I'll meet you in the next video with the next chapter. Okay? Bye.